All right, what's up, guys? Welcome to the improv show. Come on. Yeah, we're the UMass Lowell Improv Club. We do improv all the time. And we're about to perform a show for you guys. Everything you see here tonight is completely improvised. It's not written down. It's not rehearsed. It's right off the dome. And yeah, we're going to get right into it. So this is a game that's called Reverse Freeze. So how this works is we're going to have two actors doing a scene in kind of, you know, main stage. And, you know, we'll just call out Murph Dog and Matt O'Halloran. And so these are our two actors. And whenever I yell freeze, I'll call someone else's name. And they're going to come out and tap one of these two actors on the shoulder. And they're going to hijack whatever scene the two actors are performing and maybe make it a different scene, maybe add on to that scene. And, you know, we're just going to see what happens, you know? All right, so without further ado, let's get a prompt for our first two actors. Let's get a, you know, any kind of prompt works. You can just shout them out. Like, what was the worst thing that happened to you today?
The guy in front of you at Subway took the last bus
up. Okay.
That's a pretty good one.
Nicole. Oh, that's kind of terrible.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
I'm feeling the sub one.
Yeah.
Feeling the sub one?
Yeah.
All right. Cool. Well, without further ado, let's get started.
Yeah, can I get a meatball sub? Okay. Thanks. Chris. Did you?
Hey. Can I?
What's up?
I'm just going to order my sandwich.
Oh, okay.
Cool. Can I get a meatball sub? You're out of meatballs? You just gave meatballs to that guy. What I want?
Sir, please stop pointing at me. I'm just trying to get my sub. I don't like you pointing at me.
But you're taking my sub.
Back up. That's not your sub. It's mine. I ordered it.
I don't see your name on it.
Dude, is there my name on the receipt? It's coming up soon. I got my receipt. Dude. Give me that back.
Nope.
Give me that back.
Nope.
Dude,
you'll have to kiss me for it.
Freeze! Felipe!
You think you're better than me?
Maybe.
Huh?
I don't know. I could be.
Prove it.
Okay, watch this. Balloon animal. Elephant. You ever seen a balloon elephant in your life? No.
Yeah.
That's why I'm the best clown in this whole town, and you're nothing, okay? Why don't you get
a
your little car
elephant?
And drive off?
Is that
yeah.
really is that
yeah.
the best you can do?
Yeah. What can you do, huh?
Try it.
Do something.
That's a whole bicycle.
What can I do with this? Ride it, dude? I sit on it, I pop it.
Yeah, try it.
Whoa, dude, how's this holding my weight? Dude, what are you putting this?
I told you.
Dude, this is not helium.
I'm the real clown here.
Dude, this is too serious. Dude, you're freaking me out. I want to be laughing. I don't even know. You just made a new element with this.
Freeze, Rob.
See this hand?
Yeah, dude.
See this hand? Yeah. You wanna know where this hand's been?
A lot of places, I imagine.
Oh yeah,
a lot.
Yeah.
I'm sorry about your mother.
No.
The memorial and everything. I didn't mean to go that hard.
Are you telling me now, of all times,
yeah.
that you did it?
Yeah. Listen.
How did this
no,
come
no,
to
no.
happen?
I just want to say that I think we can still be friends. We can
We can walk out
after
of here.
You fucking killed my mom?
Listen, you ever hear of a crime of passion? There are a bunch of people sing about it all the time. This could be a song.
And what, you want me to write the song?
No, I'm going to write it, but you can play like guitar.
Oh, my God. Okay.
I think I was being nice showing up at the memorial. You know, I could have just run away to, like, Cuba or Canada for refuge, but I showed up to stick it out like a man.
Before I walk away and forget you.
Come on.
What passion of crime? What crime of passion did you commit against my mom?
Well, I don't want to get too in detail, but you ever hear of BDSM?
Freeze, Megan.
You can't even look at me right now. I'm so upset.
Oh, why?
You know what you did.
But I still want to look at you.
No. I want to hear your dirty mouth admit what you did.
You got to be a lot more specific.
My dog?
Oh. Fred. You know, I just heard that, like corn dogs, I didn't know that they weren't made with, you know, dogs. So.
I thought you just stole my dog. You ate it?
Oh, no.
You,
yeah.
No,
I took him to a farm, yeah.
I thought I was coming to get my dog back. I thought you just stole him.
No, I did steal him. You know, I didn't eat him. That was just a joke, you know.
So where is he?
Fred?
You're just making that sound with your mouth.
Oh shit, there, he just left. He just jumped out the window.
You're just trying to trick me now.
No, I wouldn't do that, no. I care about this friendship way too much.
You just see a dog on the ground and you just, food?
No,
a corn dog is not a dog.
Well,
I
know.
A hot dog is not.
Well, technically, it was.
Freeze, Charles.
I know. Just gotta get our stretches in. Just gotta start. Get our stretches in.
I know. Okay.
Preparing so hard for the triathlon.
Yeah, what triathlon are we doing? Like, you just signed me up for this. I just kind
of. Yeah, I know. I should have warned you ahead of time, but.
I'm also like it takes me like.
You ever hear Sonic the Hedgehog?
10 minutes to run a mile, I'll be fine, right?
Yeah, that should be all right, I guess. How long does it take you to run, like, 4 miles?
I don't make 4 miles. I don't know how I'm gonna...
Okay.
I'm just hoping, like, this routine would work, so, like...
Yep, I get it. It's,
yeah.
It can be kind of hard to, you know, go for a full triathlon.
Can I be, like, one of those people that just, like, hands cups of water instead?
I guess so. I mean, there's nothing
like,
really stopping
me. How do I get
out
of this? You signed me up. Now, oh my God, now I'm having a panic attack. I can't run this long.
All right, come on. You got this.
Okay, let's do the practice, like.
Yeah, of course, the practice.
Yeah, okay. All right. Okay. No,
right.
You gotta come. Like,
sorry, I thought we were doing the other practice.
What? Okay, no, it's fine.
Freeze. Evan.
Some good floor. Man,
I love floors.
I had never seen a floor that floory.
I know. Should we just like take it? Like we should just like take a piece of it off, right? And like
yeah, sample for the lab.
Yeah.
I like the way you think.
Yeah, it's just we'll just
right
cut
over
it,
here.
Right?
Yep.
No, say a huge piece. Like I feel like
wait.
A piece this big would.
All right,
be.
You do it then.
I will.
Yeah.
So like, they won't see this. We'll
but
just put something over it.
It's like a work of art. You're just ruining it.
Yeah. Okay.
All right.
They won't notice that hole, right?
I mean.
No. Like,
now that I'm looking at it.
We'll just put something over it.
I kinda like the hole better.
You like the hole better?
Oh man. Can we get a piece of this hole? Oh, give
Why
me the
don't
knife.
We take hole?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yup. Oh my gosh.
That's great.
That's gonna look great on our wall.
It really is. We should just like frame it too.
Of course. But what kind of frame is gonna suit a hole like this?
Really good one. Like Michael's.
Yeah.
We should go.
Michael's has a good floor. Ooh. Michael's has a good floor.
Freeze. Andy.
So where are we going again?
I thought you knew.
You said we could just hop out of the car and you not knew which way the city was. And now we're in the woods. Why are we in the woods? The woods aren't for like at least a couple states over.
Right. Yeah. Because we're in that one state that doesn't have any woods.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because, you know, all the woods are gone.
But like, this is kind of nice, right?
No,
surprise,
I hate woods.
We're in the woods.
I hate the woods.
That's...
Do you see
sense.
Those trees? Those are ugly as shit.
Oh my god. What did that tree ever do to you?
Exist.
Yikes. Alright, well, like, have you ever tried to, like, you know, talk to him? I'm sure he's got a nice tree. Come on. Let me... You see the mighty oak? Give it a slap. Yeah.
It looks like it's about to fall over.
Are you kidding me? It's like 10 feet wide. This is a huge tree.
It's very flimsy though.
Oh my gosh, you know nothing about, you know, this is probably why you live in wherever it is you live. I feel like I don't even know you anymore.
Freeze, Issa.
I'm sorry I ran over your cat. I know that it's traumatic.
You know, that's...
I once had that happen to me, and I'm still not over it, so I understand.
It's not even the worst part. You know?
Really?
You ran over my cat, and you know, that's right, he was kind of old. You know, maybe he had to come in.
A little bit.
But you scratched my car, man.
You told me I could drive it.
You told me you drive safely, but
all
look,
I did was hit a couple trees. I don't see the big
see,
deal. And then your cat.
Does that look like
that.
a couple trees? Does that look like a couple trees
it's
to you?
It's just like a forest.
Look at this grass. It's at least 3 inches long. All right. That's not
it's
small.
It's 1 inch three times. Now, if you put it like that. Does it really seem like a lot? Because
so,
I don't think so.
So you scratched my car three times. Is that what's up?
No, I scratched that once. That's really, that's fully in the mathematics of that. Trust me, my roommate's a math major. I know this stuff. Listen. I know it looks bad. Like, the axis probably a little fucked up. The window completely shattered. I think... To be honest, it is a little more than a scratch. I don't really know how that happened. I hit the gas. We were in the woods. Wow. I love your cat, man. I think I'm more upset about that than, like.
Well, I'm more upset about the car. So, what are you gonna do to fix this?
I can't afford a new car, but I can afford a new cat. So.
Yeah, but you can't bring Mittens back.
Well, maybe. I was reading up online about this potion.
Oh my god, this again?
And then you just...
What are you gonna pour it on my car? Huh? You're probably talking about the cat.
I was, but maybe it'll work on the car too if you really care about the car.
I do.
Okay, well we could try that.
All
we need is a couple leaves. Which were all around us.
Right.
Because
we're in a forest.
And some werewolf thing.
Right.
We could probably get that somewhere.
No?
You know a guy?
I know a few guys. None of them have werewolf names, but they might. I've never really asked.
That's cool.
I don't know. I'm sorry, dude.
Yeah. I mean, maybe we should just accept our fate. Because we're out here in the woods.
Yeah.
And
I should really put
like
my headlights
3 hours
on next time.
From civilization.
It's like pitch dark out. I don't know why.
All right.
All right. Our next game is called Stakeout. How this game works is we're going to have two cops sitting in these chairs staking out two criminals who are performing a crime that me and Megan are going to talk about. But also, we will get a prompt for that crime. So, yeah.
Let's get started. What crime are these two? What crime do you guys envision these two folks getting into? Any other crimes? You can say crimes you guys have done.
They're shoplifting their bonus keys, but they're not a student, and it is 2022.
They're throwing jelly beans at oncoming traffic.
You
go to the improv show.
Oh, the biggest crime.
Yeah.
Walking to a crowd of movie theaters and screaming fire.
Oh.
Leaving unconsensual tattoos.
That's a good one. Do you guys like any of those prompts?
Yeah, I like permanently disfiguring.
Yeah.
Okay, sweet.
You can get tattoos.
Let's get started. Yeah. Oh, I hate being a cop.
It's been a long day.
So many years on the force. I just want to go home and see my wife.
I'm new, so.
Yeah, no, you're a rookie.
This is literally day one.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
No, I'm Sullivan.
Oh.
Sergeant Sullivan. Oh. Okay.
Okay.
I'm a sergeant. Oh, look at these two suspicious characters. Mm. What the hell? Whoa, are they giving tattoos to homeless people?
Looks like it. That's weird.
Can they do that?
Does it say they can?
Do you have? I don't know.
You're. I'm a rookie.
Hey, it's your first day. You should know this stuff, okay? Yeah, I don't think they're allowed to do that. I mean,
they could almost like be dead. Like they're not moving.
I mean, maybe you're right, but I don't know. What is? Oh, now they're both tattooing the same guy on his face?
Oh.
What the hell? Oh my god. Don't put a penis on his face, guys. The guy's homeless.
No, they're just like scratching his face with a needle. Like,
oh my
even...
god. What the hell? Are these guys tattoo artists? Or are they just
I feel like they just found the needle on the street.
Oh yeah, yeah. They don't even have any. Oh my god. Yeah, they do not have the proper
tools.
They
have a needle and a Sharpie. Like, that's like...
Oh my god. This is going horrible.
Yeah, but I'm like kind of intrigued as to like what's going to happen.
I know. I think they're doing fine. As long as they don't grab that stray cat that's walking by them.
Yeah.
That would be perfect. Oh no, they grabbed... Oh my god.
You called it.
Dude,
if you didn't say anything...
I swear to god, if they start needling...
God.
Oh, what are they dipping him in? Oh my god.
Guys, you not see that?
Oh my god.
As long as they don't eat it, right?
As long as they don't eat it. I mean, we're cops.
Yeah.
We kind of determine what the
they
law is.
They don't have utensils with them to eat it.
Yeah,
oh,
they don't.
He's going for it.
Oh my god.
He's just
like, going into it.
Is that like legal?
I don't think that's... Listen, Roki, there's a lot of stuff you need to learn out here,
but like,
right?
Do you know?
Look, I don't know per se. But I think what they're
like,
yeah, I don't know. I mean, I guess as long as they don't like kill anyone that walks by, or,
yeah,
I don't know.
Like, no one walks down the street except that guy.
Yeah. Oh my god.
The cat just like killed him.
Oh yeah.
Just like knocked him. Oh, now what are they throwing? Are they throwing their needles?
They're throwing the homeless people.
At what?
Off the bridge.
Oh my god.
Now, they're killing you with needles.
Oh my god.
Can we get up?
We should probably like arrest them.
Yeah.
For, you know, doing this. So,
freeze! Any final words?
It was just a stick and poke.
Bang!
That was good.
Stick and poke.
Okay. That was a fun little game. The next game we're going to play is called the Dating Game. Let's get Issa, Andy, Charles, and Murph Dog up here.
Issa, get the hell out of here.
Okay. So how this game works is we are going to have three contestants on our dating show. Issa is going to be the host, or she's going to be the bachelor on the dating show. So basically how it works is Issa's going to come back in and she's going to have to guess the identities of these three potential mates that she's trying to get with, you know? So, yeah, let's get three identities for our contestants or our bachelors. They can be historical figures, they can be superheroes, they can be...
Lizzie Borden.
What'd she do?
Amelia Earhart.
That's a good one. Amelia Earhart.
David Hasselhoff.
David Blaine.
Thomas
Jefferson,
Professor X, Dumbledore. I like David Blaine.
Let's just get one more of them.
Lord Farquaad. Dr. Phil.
That's the guy from Shrek, right?
Yeah. Okay. Okay, let's go over it one more time.
David Blaine.
Amelia Earhart.
Lord Farquaad.
Yes. I'll take over Evans.
She just texted me, he's like, going to the bathroom quick, text me when we come back in. She's gone.
He did look concerned when he walked out. He lost her?
She's gone.
Kieran, what the hell?
She's not there.
She's dead.
In her defense, we've never come up with a real thing.
Yeah.
That's true. I mean, the whole show was Jesus dead. Jesus gonna die. Well, I guess it happened.
It's crazy.
So good.
We lost her for a minute.
The day when she texted me, she was going to the bathroom. I knew all that. Isabel, you gave up so fast.
Yeah, she said off her email.
You gave up so fast.
Alright. Welcome to the dating show, guys.
Thank you. Thank you. Alright. We got one very eager bachelor today. Bachelor, what's your name?
My name is Carl. I'm 35 and I live with my mother. So.
That's cool. You didn't need to share that much, Carl.
All right.
Carl, I hear you're looking for love. Is that what's going on?
Just a little bit. I want someone to cook me dinner and maybe some other things, so.
Yeah, maybe some other
ready
things.
Ready for it.
Heck yeah. Well, lucky for you, Carl, we got three secret contestants here today.
Nice.
And they're all going to be competing for you.
For me?
All right, to cook you food and do other stuff with you.
Oh, man. I've never had that before.
Yeah. Welcome to television, kid.
Oh.
Yeah.
Hey, man, I'm 35.
I know.
Okay.
Okay. So, yeah, whenever you're ready, Carl, you can start asking your contestants whatever questions you need to ask,
all right? All right. The first one is going to be for all three. Like I said, I want someone that'll cook me dinner. So what would you cook and how? All three of you.
I'm not a great cook, but I'd probably be able to make something appear pretty quickly and suddenly. And I think you'd be surprised by it in a delightful way.
Okay, that sounds wonderful. I like quick. I like surprises. You know, thank you.
You're welcome.
Contestant number two, have a hard competition already off the bat.
Yeah, I think I could probably do some peanuts and pretzels, but that's probably about it.
Damn, that is not great.
I mean, you know, the food's just gone to shit nowadays.
Like, no lasagna or baked ziti. I really like pasta, man.
I mean, I could. It's just I don't really spend a lot of time in a kitchen. Like, I spend my time all around the world, you know?
That is not a winner for me. But, well, we're going to move on. What about contestant number three?
Well, I can say I'm going to blow everyone out the water because I am the best contestant here. I don't need to cook. I have cooks to cook for me. They do all the cooking, the cooks.
Well,
so they can cook for you.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
You had me worried there for a second. I was like, who's going to do my cooking? Usually it's my mom, but I don't know. That brings me to my second question. All three of you, would you be okay with moving in with my mother? And if not, why? And if so, also why? Please tell me.
I think I could handle whatever your mother throws my way. You know, if she's a very cold woman, I'm good at staying in cold environments for hours and hours and hours on end. I've done it before. You can look it up. It's actually on the internet. But yeah, I'd be cool with it.
Awesome. That sounds great. Contestant number two?
Is your mother's house a secretive place? Because, like...
I wouldn't say so. It's in Nashville.
Oh, boy. I don't think I could live in there, though. Apparently, a lot of the world thinks that I've gone missing. Like, it's kind of a sad story. I mean, like, I'm used to cramped spaces. And, like... Does it happen to be near any, like, high altitude, like, mountains?
No, man. It's pretty flat.
Okay, I think I could adjust. Maybe.
All right. I'm going to be honest.
I'll leave you on a maybe.
I'm not feeling you. Whatever. Contestant number three?
No. I have dealt enough of women. I tried to date a princess one. I, you know, kidnapped her, then I tried
mother.
To marry her. And then she just went off and married this other green dude. And then I got eaten by a dragon. So now I've moved on. So I will not be talking to your mother, ever.
You sound cool. Seems like you might be a little short for me, though. I don't like people under.
Short people are cooler, though.
I don't think so, Farquaad. I really don't. I still like you more than number two, I'm thinking. So we'll see about that. This one's just for one and two. What if you were gonna take me on like our anniversary, like big anniversary, like 3 years we're talking, where would you take me? Because I need to be pampered, like a little baby, but I'm 35.
Probably take you to a bunch of street corners, you know. I can usually get some crowds going, so you know people would appreciate you, you know. Just a pretty low-key guy, you know? But for you, you know, I'd go anywhere, you know? I mean, right now you might be getting my heart rate up to like 55, even, beats per minute. You're really pushing the limits.
Beats per minute?
Yeah, 55, that's like a high for me. I'm usually in like the 40s. Just chill.
Right.
Yeah.
I feel.
Yeah.
Contestant number two?
Yeah, I could really take you anywhere around the world, especially with these newfangled airplanes we got here. You know, it's gone with the two-seater now. I could take you, I could take your mother, I could take your friends. Anywhere you want. Just as long as we have enough battery in the radios. Don't want that incident happen again.
Huh. You can take my mother. I'm liking you more now. Wow, that's crazy. I don't...
Yeah, it might be a bit hard with all this newfangled technologies that we have, but, yeah, I think I can make it work. I mean, you know, if the first of my kind, the first pilot of my kind, can, you know, figure out how to fly one of those old-fashioned ones, a newfangled one shouldn't be all that bad.
Yeah, I don't think women should be able to fly planes, though. I was actually pretty against you when I heard about it. So, I don't know about that one.
Aren't you looking for a woman partner?
It's unclear to me. I'm exploring.
Yeah, I can take that.
Bachelor number one, because I'm liking you the most right now. What? When we're married after 30 years, what would be the thing that surprises me about you the most? What could you still bring to the table that would keep me surprised, keep me energized, keep me focused, keep me on that grind? And how would it be better than what my mother already does? Because I'm gonna need some answers.
A lot. I could stab myself through the hand, no blood. Hold my breath for an hour. Be buried for a couple of days if you ever want to get a break. Do a lot of stuff that could probably surprise you.
Okay. Well, Michael, that sounds good. No, not Michael? Damn.
Sorry. I just like doing crazy stunts.
Do you? Oh, okay.
But like of the physical nature, where I like wait in places, like hold my breath underwater, I like being blocks of ice.
You're like
frogs.
A magician.
You could say that. Yeah, you could.
Like a famous one?
Yeah, I'd have money.
Like Houdini or something?
Yeah, kind of like that. I'd have a lot of money. I could even make more appear if I want to.
Oh. Oh.
Yeah.
What, like Harry Potter? Or
like
that?
I guess so. I mean,
or you're going for it. You're doing magic tricks?
Doing street magic.
But you're not killing people.
No. I
That's
mean,
a bummer for me.
I'm almost dying sometimes, but
okay.
Still alive.
But you're alive.
Yeah, for now.
Huh. Contestant number two. Are you Amelia Earhart?
Quite possibly.
I'm liking you. Don't love that you fly. You should really stick them up. They should keep that job for the men. But
this is why I went missing for several years. Possibly locked up. I can't remember. I have some kind of amnesia because I believe I'm like over 130 years old.
Yeah, that's crazy.
This is why I went missing. I thought things would be better for women in this modern era.
Chuck's
on
you.
No.
Chuck's on you, man.
I got nothing to say about this. Wait, I just saw my mouth shut. With noodles. And stirred.
Honestly, I don't think you know who it is.
Well, contestant number one, I don't know who you are, but I like you. I think I'm gonna choose you.
Woo! Matt,
who
are you?
David Blaine.
I've never heard of him.
Yeah. What?
Yeah. I think everyone on, like, you guys know me more than like anyone. I don't know why you thought.
I was gonna say, would you know David Blaine?
And yet no one said anything.
It's okay.
It's okay.
I remember.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you need to watch more magic videos.
Yeah, watch David Blaine.
Cool. Alright. Our next game is called Jump Styles. Evan, Rob, get over here.
So how this game works is we're going to have two actors doing a scene, and throughout the scene, we're going to come up, well, before the scene, we're going to come up with some genres for them to switch in and out of throughout the scene that they are performing. So it could be documentary, romance, horror, memoriam. It can be anything you can put your mind to, you know? So, yeah, what genres can you guys think of for these two actors?
Dr. Seuss book.
Okay. Dr. Seuss. What?
I think the word was Morbid Erotica.
Yeah.
Interesting.
I don't see you writing it down.
Oh, yeah, it did.
LARPing.
What?
LARPing.
LARPing? Give me, like a middle school play.
Middle school play?
Middle school play.
Yeah. It's pretty good. These aren't really genres, but...
That's a genre? Are you kidding me?
Middle school? Middle school play?
Yeah, the actual performance in middle school.
Okay.
Yeah.
Any other genres?
What?
Coming of
age?
It's a good one.
That is a good one.
Jeopardy?
Oh,
I like Jeopardy too, though.
I already own Jeopardy.
All right, let's get one more.
There's two more.
What?
Monty Python.
Cool. All right. Now that we've got our genres, let's get a scene for these two folks. What's the worst thing that's ever happened to you guys? Just shout it out. Shout it out. Yeah, you don't have to share.
It doesn't have to be that. It could be anything.
It could be the worst experience you've ever had, maybe the best experience you've ever had. One time, Issa and John went on a date, and someone thought that Issa was John's daughter.
Yeah, we were in a Walmart, and the cashier was like, is that your daughter?
Okay, you guys want to do that?
Do it.
Okay, cool. Alright, you're both dating, but you're in the line at Walmart, and you're not suspecting anything to happen, and you love each other very much.
Alright, justice, please. Card.
Thank you.
I'm sorry. You... Wait.
Oh.
Hold on. this is my girlfriend. Whoa. Dude, that was
flattered.
What? What do you mean you're flattered?
Well, thinks I look young.
Alright, dude, just take the cash. That's alright, keep the change. Let's get out of here.
No, I want to stay.
What?
Maybe we can play.
What? Play?
Yeah, play. You know.
This is a Walmart.
Exactly.
And
there are toys and boys.
How dare you say she's my daughter? Your mother smells like elderberries, or something like that.
Elderberries?
Yeah.
I smell like elderberries.
Is that what that perfume is?
No. That's my natural musk.
Wow. You do smell like elderberry.
Do you like it?
I quite like it.
Squire.
Wow. I've never felt like this before.
Pray tell.
Well, you see, the elderberries, they've entered my nostrils, and I must tell you, I'm feeling rather excited.
Oh, excited?
Yes.
Mm.
But we must leave this Walgreens then.
Yes, we shall. No, horse.
Oh.
Separate.
I see.
Middle school play.
I deserve the lead. Me. You're on stage. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Tenton Middle School's...
You don't have any lines. You're a tree.
Romeo and Juliet.
This is Hamlet.
Hamlet. I am Hamlet. Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears.
What?
Come to Barry Caesar. No.
Coming of age.
What's wrong?
My body's changing. And I don't like it.
Just because he said you were my daughter doesn't mean you're going through reverse puberty, all right? That's a myth.
I think it does.
It doesn't exist, Wendy.
I used to be sexy. People mistook me for Shakira.
Oh, well, that's because your hips, they only tell the truth.
That's true.
Your hips are still hipping. You're just as you were yesterday.
Turning 21, I can't be mistaken for a five-year-old. How am I gonna get let into bars? You're gonna get into bars and I'm not.
You have an ID, you just show them it, kind of gets who it is.
That's what lame people do. I'm a woman now. I shouldn't have to show an ID, I should just have to show these.
What do you mean now? How have you always been a woman?
Well, ever since, I guess, I hit puberty. I think 14.
Large.
I am a woman!
And I'm a 54 level knight!
54, only 54.
Taste my divine smite!
You
whoa!
Missed.
I will win your hand in marriage!
Not if I use fireball!
Yeah! Anti-fireball spell!
Damn it! Oh, potion time. Sensual woman potion! How dare ye!
I smacked the potion!
How dare ye! That was my only potion. Now, I shall do it the old-fashioned way. With my hands.
Oh, well, hold on! That's against the rules.
Yeah, well, he threw my potion away.
Yeah, because it was too high a level for you. You can't unlock that potion until level 3.
I'm 21!
Yeah, well, you're a second level bard or whatever.
That was a mistake. I put the wrong character sheet there. I didn't mean... I'm not a bard, I'm a knight.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah!
You don't look like much of a knight to me. You look like you could be that guy's daughter.
I'm a knight, and you shall refer to me as Dame Beatrice. Dame.
That's kind of cool, actually. It's
very cool.
Yeah, no, I
came up with it myself.
Yeah.
Parody of Jeopardy.
All right, thanks for coming. Today, we just have one guest, the other two had better things to do.
But anyway.
Thank you, Bob.
Tell us about yourself.
Well, I'm Beatrice.
I'm 21 years old, and I have written...
You don't look a day over five.
Five? Five? I'm 21.
Yeah, it was a compliment, sweetie.
That's not a compliment. If that were a compliment, you are basically telling national television that my boyfriend is committing a crime.
Right, all right, let's just get those categories on the board.
Okay.
All right, first up we have English literature by young women. People that are famous at the age of five.
Not funny.
Women that look much younger than they actually are. All right. And you have the board.
Okay. Who is...
You got to pick a category.
I thought you were saying the category.
Right.
How old are you, Bob?
Well, I'm 21.
Don't look it.
Well, how old do I look?
You look like a walking corpse. They need to put more makeup on that.
Coming of age and end it. Are you okay?
I'm just so tired of all of it.
It seems like you're violently coming of age.
I was embarrassed on Jeopardy.
Like it's all happening at once.
My LARP, the school play. I'm not five, I'm 21.
Listen, I can drink.
I'm legal!
Everybody hits reverse puberty at some point.
Not everybody.
It's
not Benjamin Button.
It's
I'm
natural.
Beatrice.
Listen, it's going to be okay.
Is it?
It happens to everyone.
Thank you, Dad.
Cool. So Issa, you or John? So wait, Issa, John's really your father?
I just don't get it. Like, not even like sister or cousin.
Has a low for the night.
Its projector turns on.
Let's get it started.
Okay, so this presentation already has fine. We don't need a new title. We can work around it. So basically this is a presentation these three people have never seen before in their entire lives. And they're gonna present it. And it's gonna be pretty good. And they're gonna do maybe three slides each. Maybe one of them will do four slides. I don't know.
Welcome to, what are we presenting?
Your business people presenting a new business idea.
All right, welcome to my company. I started it up, I am president. Actually vice president, but we'll forget about that. Pissing, shitting, and coming, PSC. So the first thing we're gonna talk about first, let us introduce ourselves. The current business climate. Right now. Sharks, like Shark Tank. Current business. Chipmunks. Sharks eat chipmunks. We don't want that to happen anymore. That's the business model. The food chain, wrong. They're doing it all wrong. So the Shark Tanks, they invest in the businesses, but then they also, you know, eat chipmunks. We don't want that to happen anymore. So here's what we're gonna do to fix it. The problem. Here's what we're gonna do to fix the problem, right? We're gonna take out this and replace it with this, both guns. One of them way less violent. Now, this is a wheel for people to spin on. So what I'm thinking is we replace the humans with the sharks. Or vice versa. So once you get on to the wheel, we're gonna put the sharks on the wheel. They can't eat the chipmunks anymore, but they can invest in businesses. No chipmunks eating, yes investing. So And also no more guns. That's a different problem, but we decided to just tack that on. And I know you're all very bored, like in that photo. So the solution is this again. So you see that this gas pump kind of looks like a gun, but it's not. They're using it to pee. Gunshots are loud. Cover your ears. You're on the toilet. You need your gas pump. You don't have it. You're reading the newspaper. You see an ad for free gas pumps. And then these guys, they come up to you and they start saying lies. Well, not the evolution thing. That's real. That's true. No, the banana and the knight, they come up to you. They give you a gas pump. So without further ado, I'm going to bring out our vice president, Billy Bob James, and they're going to give you a little more info on what the hell I was just talking about. No one knows. They're going to talk about it.
Hello, it's Billy Bob James, and I'm going to introduce you to our concept. Well, the first thing in PSC is pissing, which is what that monkey over there is doing. You might not see it, but that monkey is in fact pissing on those people down there. Now, that's why there's a table there. You can like barely see it right there under his laptop. And then those two people, they're shitting on the chipmunks. We want them to stop. That's why shitting is step two. Stopping people from shitting is our second priority, right after making that monkey piss. I don't know what that guy is doing. He was just there in the meeting when we were discussing this. And he said we should put it humming. And he liked sharks. But we don't like sharks. They eat chipmunks. So what do we do about that? We bring in our competitors. The dog that looks like a cat will be eating the sharks. The man with a hat and a beard will be eating the dog. The people wearing sombreros will be eating the man with the hat and the beard. And that dude will be setting a nice melody for it all. Together, they are pissing, shitting, and coming. What's the price, though? We need to think about the price. What's the price of shitting? It's those bottles right there. That man is so frustrated. He's been doing this his entire life. And look at them. That all the bottles that contain all the piss and the shit and the cum. That was him when he first started buying them. And then the chipmunks stole away all his money. So the sharks ate them. I'm gonna pass it off to my friend, Jimmy Joe Jr., who will teach you all about that.
All right, guys. My name's Jimmy Joe Jr.,
JJJ for short. And let's get into the deets of this business. We've thrown a lot of information at you, a lot of piss, a lot of shit, and even more cum. So let's break down where all that piss, shit, and cum is coming from. All right. Elon Musk, he does a few things. Some of those things, pissing, shitting, and cumming. And you best believe this guy repeats, too. That's how you become a billionaire. You think it was because of Tesla? Or because of SpaceX? No, it's because that man bottled up his bodily fluids and sold them everywhere. And there you have a satisfied customer in Pete Davidson, who, he's all about the shit. You know, he likes piss and cum too, but, you know, we all have our favorites, and he's a shit man. But that's why you gotta do all three, because not everyone's gonna want your piss or your cum. Some people are just gonna want the shit. So, thank you for listening to our new business model. I believe that
if you start running your business on the core tenets of piss, shit, and cum, you will be just as successful as this man here and be able to straighten your own tie. Thank you.
Together.